So, yeah. Oh yeah, and the Warsong are supreme, taking that stuff. While it's, oh, while at the same time yellow is coming. Wait a minute, what is that? That... Oh, they, yeah, that's actually insane, okay. It looks kind of interesting, I have to say that. Okay, and did Queen launch stuff in Outland? No, actually not, okay. Oh, what is this, what is it with messes at the moment? Dup-de-dup-de-dup. Nacewin, what do you have to complain? Oh, you have Galen Trollbane. Can't complain, actually. You have achieved quite a lot, I would say. If you already have Galen Trollbane. But from where did you get him, actually? Did you get him from Stormguard? From that area? Yeah, there's actually Stormguard, but you did not get it from him. Okay. Ah, and Pink gets that base as a second chance. Okay, so noted there's already a second chance. But he's... I don't know. It's kind of weird. In every case, people seem to keep their heroes in the second chances, but which I don't actually understand. Pink, wrong direction. Yeah, because right now you are running into Mace's junk while Terramore... not Terramore, but Dalaran is getting obliterated. Terramore got obliterated a long time ago. Oh, and that cannon tower is still neutral, so it never got launched. So you should fix that. Ooh. Yeah, Kevin Tor fighting over passing issues. Huh. That's all too interesting to watch. Lordaeron is quite... Yeah, dead. Nobody really cares for it. I'm still having my pet with Queen, because I have no other enemy to face at the moment, since Lordaeron got wiped out, but yeah. So... It's interesting to see. So let's focus on Usa a bit. Usa is still back in his Warsong base. He actually has no enemy to fear currently. Apart from... Oh, now it's Nacewin versus Usa. Ah, okay. So now matches are shaping out a bit. Oh, and Frizz as the Satyrs. Ah, he's still in the game. Though he gets actually that territory. He's now attacking Nacewin from behind. Huh. Yeah. My god, the chances of missing. Woohoo! Those knights, though, do they have actually? Oh, 55 damage, 9 armor. Yep, yeah, they're pretty tanky. I have to give them that. What are you? Oh yeah, you're the champion. Why is the champion actually as good as a normal outrider? I don't get it. I thought those are supposed to be demi units. Okay, and here come the outriders. Okay, we slow down a little bit. And they're taking down that base. Because Usa is not defending? Where's Usa actually? Oh! Usa actually up here because he wanted to take now the stuff of Ashenvale, but now he's realizing shit, all his entire stuff is getting taken away by Stormwind. Oh. Oh god. Yeah, you can't save it. And here it comes. The Warsong versus the might of Varian Wynn. This is probably the match Garrosh would have dreamt for. Oh, Vexar getting... Oh god! Here we have the problems with the heroes again, yeah. Both getting aimed down. Nacewin's side, what is it? Nacewin... Oh, Galen, I saw that. And King Varian Wynn standing supreme. Level 20! Wow! He's like... Wow, are you kidding me? 140 damage on Varian? Wow, I know he's supreme in lore, but... Wow. Ooh. Oh, and? What did I do? Oh, yeah, that's right. Because Pink launched now his second chance. Yeah. The rage will be much now. Be prepared. As that stuff happens... Oh, and New Dalaran is also here. That also happens, that event. Yeah, and they haven't launched all the goblin mines, but perhaps it will be the case. Huh. Yeah, that's also a thing which I meant why you should also implement vision blockers, because some bases are neighbored with each other and... yeah. That's what happens. Oh, and actually, trolls can walk over here into new dollar ones, so that's also interesting to watch. Yeah, but at the same time, since so much stuff got already wiped out along with Dalaran, the dwarves of Tamni Messias are moving up here and now fighting both the elves and the might of the trolls. So yeah, it's now currently a waiting game for me to reform my entire army. I actually don't know which second chance of trolls this is already, because it's already ice trolls. I'm quite sure there will be another one in the late game, and I most likely think it will be this one. Yep. Yep, I'm pretty sure it will be this one. Don't want to spoil why, but yeah. I do not have much hope for that Dragonfly player. Still, a level 10 King of Guntrack. That's neat. Yeah, but at the same time, I'm defending my territory as well against maces, because maces is just spamming archers. Not archers, but riflemen. I'm impressed. He's holding quite well, and oh, you're building up towers, so you have here your gate. Okay, so the gates are not capturable. That's good to know. And Queen has to rebuild stuff here because he's still under siege by Maisel, but Maisel has already dropped out of the game, hasn't he? Yeah, he already has dropped out of the game. Oh yeah, and he's the Scarlet Crusade, of course. I forgot that he launched also an event. Oh, Nathan left the game? What happened, mate? What happened? Okay, so I guess he called it a game already? Even so, I can't see why. Huh. Oh! So, Usa has also launched a second chance, I guess, but now I see why he was so mad during that clan game. Yeah. Yeah, that's quite unfair. If an entire fleet of orange can just do shit. And attack him right away with Bovadus. I'm pretty sure that's not how it's called, but okay. It's quite impressive to see how many second chances they have in that game, because we have cultivars in that game now, we have now New Dalaran. It's probably too much. And yeah. The only stuff he has left now is Questworks, or he actually goes up to here, but he knows that I will definitely kill him when he goes up to the Bossum Hold, so yeah. In that case, Usa is kinda screwed. I have to agree. And thus we see a sea war between cultivars and the Questworks. We never would have thought to see that, since they are in different locations in actual Azeroth Force, but hey. Guess Usa can only be cleared for his large economy, even so. He does not spam them out. Most likely he has given up on that point. Towers are an issue, okay. Yeah, it's probably not a preferable position for him. Either way, so yeah, Elves of Silvermoon still defending. Oh god damn it. Why don't we see any gameplay? Why don't we see any gameplay? But at the same time, oh Messis yes. Messis has cleansed out this place. New Dalaran's still alive, by the way. So yeah, we don't have all too many players to face currently. Spampoli still has his stuff here. He hasn't opened the top of the Garrus though, even though he said during the TS he had found it. Yeah, he's just weaving. He's a pirate. I love it. And Vivisa is shooting his boat. God damn it, Vivisa. You're such a mean bitch. No, wait. Wait. Is it Vivisa? Oh, yeah, it's Vivisa because Sylvanas is in every case a second chance. So, yeah. Spawns make it more fun, so. Yeah, I disagree on that. The spawns are kinda imbalanced. Oh! Oh, that might be interesting. That might be interesting. I actually don't remember if we had any confrontation. Key to the top. Ah, I see. So that's how the Tempest Agaris works. Okay, never mind. So that gate is invulnerable, or I actually can't tell it because I can't click on it. Either way. So, oh, and Antonite is on low health. They're still fighting their war at the quest works. Usa now coming up to them. Yeah, let's see how that will end. But to be honest, Orange has the larger fleet at the moment. Not all too much money, but he has the larger fleet. While Usa is still producing stuff. Okay. Oh, and? It's a battle mage. Okay, I thought for a moment that was a hero. Yeah, Tamni, where are you currently? Oh, you're still fighting in Quetzalas. Ah, that's right, that's right. And now you're breaking through where I couldn't break through. See, it's just a pure archer battle. And even then, more stuff just dies on his side than on the elf side. At that point you would really think the elves are extinct, but nope. Nope. Actually, the elves are not extinct here. And people are actually taking stuff back. Oh yeah, that's right. What? Nacer? Huh. Oh no, wait, they're going for Karazhan. Dragonfly does. Yeah, because he has now his second chance with the OP Jungle Beasts. Oh. 66 to 108. Oh, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? We have seen what those Stormwind champions have for as stats. And then we have those. Wow. Hey, look at that! How is that even fair? How is that? I don't want to even know. So yeah. Magni back at the front lines. They somehow still survived against the elves though. Yeah, they might be OP even so. Your hold at Quetzalas was also quite. I'm not satisfied. Not at all. And here the Queen Elves lose all their stuff. So, yeah. Yeah, and Crestwax is still a shit position. Let me guess who gets a play. Yeah. So, yeah, Crestwax got wiped out and... I can understand it. In some way I can. I mean, let's be honest, you can aim it from the sea and... Barva. Bolus is still standing. I'm also surprised that a new Dalaran has not been taken. Dup-de-dup. Yeah, Dragonfly, you have... Oh, Bloodclot Mando here. Okay, so you actually got again a new hero. I kind of feel like Pink's the preferred child of that game when it comes to second chances, because, let's face it, other players don't have that opportunity. But here we see now Blood Elves getting launched, while Vivisa is also not in the game. Okay. Wait a minute. Level 1 Keltas? Oh! Oh god. Oh, okay. I have to agree, I feel kinda sorry for you, mate. And yep, they got actually the shipyard here for whatever reason. Okay. Level 1 Quelltas is... not the best to have, I guess. Oh, and Tamney left actually the game. Even so, he was probably the most successful player in that game. Huh. So yeah, it does probably leave us to a few factions being left in that cast. I know, it's not really the most exciting one, but... I just want to show how maps can look like. Yeah, I'm just getting rid of Tamney's stuff here. Funmat is actually now taking the stuff of New Dalavan here. And actually taking down the Temple of the Storms. Going now for... I actually wonder if he now goes for Yuxavon. Or if he just runs down... Yeah, he has New Dalavan the entire time. Well, I actually did not realize that he had New Dalavan the entire game. That's actually strange. But I, as I said, I sent once my stuff up here, and since most of my army got killed, yeah, by those landmines. Fucking landmines. If you would know that before, then you wouldn't assume it is some random trigger which actually killed nearly all your stuff. Oh, and Yuxavon is getting killed off. New Dalavan making mayhaps a return. Yeah, he died. And they take Uldur. Interesting to see. Yep. Yeah, we know. Questworks has died. Questworks has died. Oh. Oh. What the fuck is that? No, seriously, what the fuck is that? I actually don't remember that island. Is that the Lost Continent? Is that Pandaria? Anyone? Anyone remembers that island? Yeah, Queen got wiped out. Did he... Oh, he actually did not, but I'm pretty sure he's in for revenge. Oh, yep. Yeah, Uther has now become a pirate, killing down that stuff. Sinking every ship here. Hmm. Interesting. Well, at the same time, Pink is reclaiming a lot of stuff, it seems. Is he? Yeah, he's... Oh, I know that moment. It will be hurtful. Oh, yes. It will be really, really painful to see. Because right at that moment, I realized that... Silvermoon is already gone, my Scourge or my Bane from that entire game. And now I have to face this. Do we even have words for that in human language? It's... Yeah, because... See that? That's... Isn't that some kind of spirit links they have? Yeah, that's the main reason why I tried to aim down that hero. And I nearly successfully did, but yeah. Look at that range. I mean, how? I mean, look. I even make greater damage, and my stuff still dies. No, wait. Never mind. They have 87 damage. I forgot. My enemy has OP stuff. Sorry. Just thought. Well, maybe he did some good gameplay, but no. Just the amount of damage. Just the amount of damage. Always remember, kids, mass your ranged units and you might win if you have the most OP ranged units in that game. And those fucking jungle beasts, my god. What the hell? 50% hero armor, by the way. 50%, ladies and gentlemen. And they're just, yeah. I mean, see, here I tried to mess. I tried to actually defend. It has no... Yeah. No point at all. And Orange Suicide most likely his entire army here. I'm still impressed he's still in the game, yep. They killed Arthas, they're going they are now going for Frozen Throne. I actually tried to aim them with my abilities. I actually don't know what to say about that. Other than I actually tried to do stuff here, but yeah, Spirit Link, yay. Hey, slaughter! Fairness! Woo! I teleported back units even. See, I utilize all my shit I have! Everything! Everything. I defend I try to defend till my last breath. Yep, but... Oh yeah, and I also couldn't repair with my workers. Otherwise I would have had a chance, but since it's not classified as building, Frozen Throne dies a punny death. Yep. Oh, and also has some attack, but... Okay, never mind. It has range, but yeah. So yeah, that's the fairness. Frozen Throne just has to die. Yeah, I killed it myself, because I was really tired, I wanted to see Forsaken. And yeah. That's how it all went down. So the game can't last any longer, because... Oh yeah. And I realized how much health that one had. Even now, looking at this, I'm still speechless. Yeah, also the passing issues. I did not realize it in that moment. Because units getting stuck here behind the houses. And I was already wondering why my stuff gets killed off till I realized... Yep! There's still stuff. So... Yeah, fucking towers, I realized. And the other one as well. Yeah, 60,000 HP! Nope, I'm... Yeah, and here we lost me as a potential Forsaken player. Nope, I did not want to face that. But that's a say, holy shit, but Spam Police, you did a lot of stuff here. Oh, that's crazy. I love it. So you have the Eye of the yes, he has... What the fuck? All stats plus 25 life regen, spell shield and ability. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Why would you have such an item in the game? God damn it, that's way too much. Even the Eye of the Garrison Azot was is not as OP as that one. Holy shit. Oh god, you really, really need to reduce a lot of damage on that one. I guess Spam Police is just being like, yeah, I have an island and I'm pretty much fine on it. Yeah, let's see how long that game will last, because I doubt it will do any longer. So, now comes the part I haven't watched so far, since I left the game. Oh, Prawn is also still in that game. Okay. What does Prawn actually own? We actually remember him from here. He never got fought off. He actually built up his position, but he never partook in any major fights so far. Okay. Yeah, confusing as fuck, but yep. Yep. I don't know if. What the fuck is that? Oh, a Flame Leviathan. Okay. It looks okay. Judging by the stats, even though it has a lot of HP. I don't know. It's maybe too much, but well, who am I to judge? So yeah, Prawn tries now to break through. He actually has Illidan as a hero, okay. I like that. Oh yeah, that's right, that was the original bomb, because the minimap is kinda glitched. And Jaina is fighting off an Satyr. Should be careful before she gets aimed. Even though she's level 15, she should be scared of an entire host. Yeah. Yeah, see? That's why you don't get... Oh, never mind. You're teleported. That was close. That was really close. And I have to blend out Fog of War to see. Yep, that was really close. I mean, she's even now losing health. Wow. All those buffs. Ooh. Yeah. Hmm. So Queen is also in the game. I'm quite surprised. What is he doing now? He's just sitting there. Yeah, he's not doing much. Dragonfly. Yeah, Dragonfly is also not doing all too much. He launched base at least, or built one. Oh, he's fighting against Prawn. So Prawn is actually taking that stuff. He still can train Triads for some reason. I Chantrella Master, okay. Actually an interesting idea. Maybe I would tint this unit however otherwise. Apart from that, I don't mind it, it's okay. Even though the damage is quite... I don't know, that's... Just as a tip, most of the magic units should be really put on a limit where they just cast, in maximum 7 to 8 magic damage, basically. Like the regular damage a priest would do, for example. Because the thing is, if having a higher value, magic damage can become pretty strong at some point. Because magic is effective against a lot of stuff. Yeah, basically against medium armor or fortified armor and heroes. So a strong magic cost can actually kill off heroes pretty much easily without any sweat. So, okay, so you lost your position up there. Now you're fighting against Queen, okay. Okay. Final battle of Tempest Keep. While at the same time we have a battle up here against New Dalaran. Nope, okay. Then we focus on Tempest Keep. Of course we want to see the Blood Elves hold out. My god, that is quite a choke point. Have to say that at least. Yeah, it's just the elves and their siege. Okay, we have the secret of elves' durability. We found it. 100 siege damage. It's good. It's pretty good. Nothing wrong with that. Nope, nope, no. Yeah, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. 100 siege. Oh, and a phoenix as well. Hm. Oh, well. Wow. I mean, just look at the range of damage. It's... I don't know. It hurts me so much to watch. Ooh. Spam Police, are you doing... I guess you don't do anything well. Yeah, still having your island fought. And... Yeah, Queen has taken a lot of losses. Since now all players are down at the limit to not come up with the economy which they had previously, yeah. Don't have siege, yeah. I'll be waiting at the tomb, yeah, try to invade that. That's actually true. Yeah. I don't see much hope for you. Even though you do actually compete a bit with Pink. Dalaran has also mustered up their stuff. Yeah, now it's just a waiting game. Always sad when it comes to this. Ah, okay. So final battle for New Dalaran. I don't know what I should else commentate on this. It's just massing forces against other forces and spawn host against Jesus man. Yep. Yeah, everyone is so far dead except for... I don't know, I would say this is quite successful if you ask me, if you have already established the Burning Legion at the top of the Gavos. Here we see what you will face in Legion expansion. It's just the Mass of Horde Spam Police build. So, Maxeridon will be back, guys. And what was the other hero actually? I don't know if it was Kagas or... Ah, it's Red Blackhand. Yeah, Red Blackhand is totally back, guys. With Mixeridon. In the next WoW expansion. Most likely. While at the same time, Dalaran is dying, Dalaran is dying. Even though the Flame Leviathan is the only thing holding. Ooh, and yeah. Glitchy, glitchy passing issues. I just hate it when just watching those units walk, like they are like, walk, wait, walk, wait. Ooh, I hate that. It makes me really shiver. Ooh. And now some of the force are actually attacking the Queen Navy, which he does retreat at some point. I would love so much if they would just run now to Quetzalas. Yeah, of course they're running to Quetzalas, yeah, because they got lured in by the harbor. Oh god, so yeah, that's the end of Orange. Or does Orange left the game. Okay, and Pawn also left the game. So we are calling it already a game? Oh yeah, that's right, because Zagevon was actually taken. Hmm. Interesting. So, Dragonfly, Queen is in the game. Ew. Yeah, they probably have seen what Spam Police has at the top. Yeah, give me another hour, yes, if... Looking at that replay length, I doubt there will be another hour. So yeah, guys. You can write your opinion down below in the comments about that game. I know it's a horrible cast. I know it myself. I also saw that... Ooh, I could have done better on this one, but at least it's some kind of preparation. For the next one I will cast. So yeah. I don't mind it too much. I mean, it was interesting to watch what other players do out of their custom maps, but yeah, there's really a lot of stuff you have to improve. Because right at the moment, if I have to summarize all those games we have seen, it's just massing armies and yeah, clunky gameplay. Like, who has the most OP unit? No strategy matters, it's just who can spam in the most shit. And that makes me quite sad if you actually go for advanced tactics when you actually try to play that game like normal Azeroth was. You kind of fail because unit composition does not actually matter in that game. Or if it matters, just on special units. Just take the stuff which is most OP. And have, for example, that guy. Compared to a... from Dragonfly, we take... Yeah, that guy. 26 to 50 damage. You would say it's the same unit, but hey. I would say it's just imbalanced. That makes me quite sad. So, yeah. Also, I don't know what these islands are supposed to be, like... Yeah, just random. Hmm. Now I also wonder what you will implement on Twilight Highlands, because... maybe second chance for Quay? Dragonmog Clan would actually be cool, I have to admit that, but not with Qwom, you really have to replace the heroes at second chances. Also another issue, as you have seen, Pink only could win that game mainly because, yeah, he had second chance there. And, oh, another fight going on with... Ah, he's taking just the stuff here, okay. But, yeah, it's basically him returning with an overpowered second chance, and he already had a second chance, if we remind ourselves. At the same time, I don't know how much you can count this one as a second chance, Oh, the game is currently ending and... okay. He just wanted to send up a fleet. But yeah. So that was the game. I actually don't know what to say about it further. Maybe my own fault. Maybe I won't release this cast at all. I actually imagined it to be more fun. At the end, it was not that good. But it's my own fault because nobody asked me for actually casting this. I just wanted to show it off to the majority of you. Maybe I will cut stuff together so it might actually come to the exciting parts of that replay. So yeah. I hope you enjoyed it so far, and yeah. Leave a like, leave a comment, what you think is best, and yeah. Then we might see us next time. See ya!